Hello everyone and welcome back to Just Finish Coding. This is part 6 of our endless runner game which we're making on Scratch 3. So without further ado, let's get right into it.
Just Finish Coding.
Now I have to interject here that if you've not watched parts 1 to 5, please watch them before you come here because as you can see, I'm picking up from where I left off. And for this video to make sense, you need to have watched the previous ones. I will leave a card for you right here. Please watch the videos and then come right back. If you're still here, then I'm going to assume that you've watched parts 1 to 5, in which case this is going to be the last and final video in the series. And in this video, we'll be dealing with the high score. So let's get right into it. I'm going to click on the high score now, and it's important we actually have a high score variable to do something similar to what we did with the score. So I'm going to make a new variable, and this time I will click on the checkbox which says cloud variable. Let me call this high score. And by the way, if you do not have cloud variables and you're not yet a scratcher, then I mean you could skip this stage and you could probably, you know, start coding a little bit more on the Scratch online website, and you would be eventually able to access this feature. So I have it. I have this feature. I'm going to assume that most of you do too. Let's continue. Okay, so I'll set up a new variable called high score, and we can set the high score to anything. At the beginning, I don't know, I'm going to set it to some weird number like 1, 2, 3. Yeah, I'm going to set it to 1, 2, 2, 3. I'm just going to double click that line of code. That's it. And after this, the code is going to be pretty similar to the high score code. I'll just do the init stuff again. So when we receive init, just like the score, we're going to do similar stuff. So we will be hiding first. Okay, so hide all of the sprites and all the clones. Then we'll make sure that all the clones are deleted except for the sprite. So repeat 1, delete this clone just the way we did for the score. And after this, we will have a simple block to make our clones. So I'm going to call it init clones, just like the score. So init clones, click OK, throw in this block here. And within define init clones, we'll be doing essentially the same thing with a crucial exception. So first, let me create a variable called clone ID. You'll start to see what the exception is. For this sprite only, click OK, then hide that variable, set clone ID, set high score to 0. That was a mistake. So set it to 1, 2, 2, 3. Okay. So now let's set clone ID this time to 0. Okay. And we'll be creating not 5, but 6 different clones. I'll explain what the 6th clone does, but just follow me along for now. Create clone of myself. And after this, I will change not high score, but I will change clone ID by 1. Now, once we're done with all of this, I'm going to set the clone ID to -1 so that I can identify the sprite and make sure that it's hidden. So the crucial difference here is that we have a new costume, which is this cloud. So we'll have this cloud too, which is going to move onto the screen and show next to the high score in order to signify what, you know, those two numbers are. If we look at it generally with just the score, we can understand that it's a score, but looking at two numbers, we could get confused as to which is the high score, or even what is it? Is it the high score? Is it some other score? Is it someone else's score? Whatever. So this is just going to make sure, you know, we help specify that. It may not look so clear when we're looking at it within the paint mode, but it starts to look pretty good on the screen. Okay. So what I'm going to do now is head over to the score, and I'm going to drag and drop this entire block of code into the high score. So just drop the tick. And I'm going to make the changes here. So first of all, if the clone ID is 0, then we lose something altogether different. This treatment of the clone ID being 0 is going to be for clone ID -1. So all of this is going to apply pretty much the same way. Maybe I have to change all the scores to high score. So let me do that quickly. Change this to high score. Change this to high score. Change this one to high score. And change this to high score as well. So finally, there we go, that is going to be it. And within this else statement, we need one more if else. Okay, so this is going to be the case if clone ID is, oops, so if you can throw in all this within the else and put the show and go to front layer after the else. Okay, so put in all this like this, And the second exception is if clone ID is equal to 0. So in case this is the case, what we need to do is we need to move slightly before the location of the high score so that we can display it. Now the high score location needs to be different from the score. We don't want the two of them overlapping. So to do that, let's quickly fix this location first. So we'll go to X not 120, but X 127. And this is to make sure that the cloud is directly aligned with the score and the high score starts a little bit later. So go to, you'll start to see what I mean. So go to 127. And as far as our Y position is concerned, we'll not be going to 176, but a little bit lower, in this case, 150. So that's going to be our location. And if clone ID is 0, then it's very, very simple, okay? We switch costume, not to game over, but we switch it to, oops, I said switch background. We switch costume, not to number 9, but we switch it to the cloud, and then we go to a location. So we'll be going before, these things show. So I'm just going to change the X position to be slightly to the left. So I'll be going to 123 and I'll be going to Y150. And that's it. All of the logic works the exact same way we did for the score in the last video. And I mean, the high score isn't going to constantly be changing. Unlike the score, the high score is only going to change in case the score gets, beyond the existing high score. But the logic is the same. We'll still be changing it to whatever the high score is, even if that high score is static and not changing all the time. Now, let's add in that exception right here. When we receive a check, let's check each and every time, if the high score is been beaten by the current player's score. So grab a less than or, greater than from operators, and you can just say if score is greater than high score, then what we need to do is we will set the high score to the score. And if we do this, the score is constantly going to change. And this is going to give the high score the animation as well. Or maybe what I'll do is I will set high score to like 15 at the start so that we can see the high score changing as well. So I'm going to click that and finally press the green flag. So now you can see that the cloud is kind of messing up with the high score, and I think that's because our high score is smaller in size. So if you look at it, the size is 100 here, but if you look at the costume of the high score, that just takes 0, and you look at the score, you'll start to see that the score has pretty big costumes. So what we need to do is essentially change the width or the spacing between the elements of between the clones of the high score. So I'm going to change this 20 to be 14. That is the width we need, and this should make everything all right. So for some reason, the cloud seems to be overlapping with my numbers. So I will check this code out once to see if there's any mistake I made, and then I will be right back. All right, so I am back, and the error is pretty simple. Okay, so all I messed up was the fact that I used clone ID. I had to use clone ID instead of clone ID minus 1. Now remember, in the score I had to use clone ID minus 1 because clone ID 0 was equivalent to clone ID 1 in this case, and we already have it in this case going to a location, so we wouldn't want the same clone ID going back to the same location. I mean, we were just overlapping them instead of making sure that they go to two different locations. Don't worry about that, just change this code. And now when we press the green flag, you can see that this already looks a lot better. So I'm gonna try and beat the high score, and you can see that once we change it, the high score starts to move as well. Now when the game is over, we can start to see that, this little incision shows us the score and the high score. And when we click play again, we start the game. And that, ladies and gentlemen, is your entire Endless Runner game. I sure have had a hell of a time making this series, and I do hope at this point you have a totally working game as well. If you've enjoyed this game series, please consider clicking on the playlist on your screen right here, and that will take you to a brand new game segment. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next series.